This is the intro to Long Hair Pretty Nails Show. Yeah.
Hey y'all, what's up and welcome back to my channel. And please do not judge my left hand. I know I'm gonna take care of that. But in this video, I'm gonna be testing out this $800 nail printer.
Well, this should be interesting.
And as some of you guys know, I am expecting, so I will finally be doing my gender reveal. So I originally bought the pink nail printer because you guys know I love pink, but they did contact me shortly after to let me know that the pink was out of stock, and so I had to choose a different color. So I chose blue, and they threw in an extra ink cartridge and some transparent gel paint. The customer service was awesome, so I definitely give a thumbs up to that. So I'm pregnant and my concentration is just all off, so hubby was so kind enough to set this printer up for me. There are a lot of steps, but it does come with a booklet that, you know, you step by step it. And also, if you need additional help, you can always call them. They've reached out to me and asked me if I needed help, so you know, that's definitely a route that you can do.
Press the switch twice in a row, you'll hear the sound dee, dee, dee. They actually wrote that.
I know, that's what I read to you. Remember, I read that to you.
Bruh. What you mean pop out?
So yeah, the instructions are they're in a layman's terms, so you'll be able to set it up.
Every time you beep, you scared.
I'm just looking to see what it's gonna do anyway. All right, it's in there, bro.
All right, so after he set everything up for me, the next thing you have to do is download the app. So I went to the app store and, you know, I'm just browsing through, seeing what the reviews are talking about. And as you guys can see, some people are just not happy at all. But this is the only way that you can use this. So I went ahead and download the app, and we're going to go ahead and install that and open it up. So it's asking for all of these permissions. So I understand they need permissions to your photos and media. But then when it came to the phone calls, I'm like, what y'all need that for? So deny. And then this message pops up in Mandarin. And I'm like, I cannot read that. So I hit the red button and it kicked me out the app. So it's asking me again, do I allow all of these permissions? And I'm like, no, deny, deny. And every time I deny, it knocked me out. So eventually, I had to agree to give over my whole life. And you finally get to the English side of the app, and then you have to agree to all these terms. And yeah, I went ahead and agreed to that. And then this is where you set up and register your account. So these are my nails. Please do not judge my left hand. Some of you guys know that I dyed my hair red, so whenever I comb it, touch it, or do whatever, my nails stain. So I definitely should have worn gloves. On my right hand, these are my Halloween nails that I did a couple weeks ago. They're liquid tip Beetlejuice inspired nails. I'll leave the video down below if you guys didn't check that out, but they are still on. And I really do like how the tanks turned out. Super cute. But I'm gonna go ahead and take all of this off. I'm only doing one hand, y'all know how I do, so we're gonna take care of this expeditiously. The first thing I'm gonna do is clip off the excess length because they're all broken up anyway. And then I'm gonna use my cuticle pusher to push back my cuticles and use the opposite end to scrape up any of that dead skin. I'll be sure to leave links to everything that I use down below. Next, I'm going in with this cuticle flame bit, and I'm gonna work that around the cuticle to further get up any of that dead skin. And then I'm just gonna use that on my whole nail to take off the red staining. I saw a video on Instagram that a girl was doing this with a hairstylist that had her nails tinted black, and it worked perfectly. So I was like, I can do that. So yeah, this is after prepping and removing all of the staining on my nails, and it came out really well. Like, I didn't think I was gonna be able to get all that off. So finally, I'm just gonna go in with my buffer and just buff the nails to kind of smooth everything out. So this is after all of my nails are prepped. Like I said, I'm just doing one hand today, so yeah. But I got some new brushes from Alpha Brush, and this set here is their nail art brush set. I had one of these years ago, and it's just time for some new brushes. So they were kind enough to send these over to me, and I really like using these. These are majority of the nail art brushes that I use. They work very well, and they are affordable. And I also picked up a number 8, a number 10, and a number 2 3D acrylic brush. When I was starting off with acrylics, these are the brushes that I used because they were affordable. and they work pretty well for me. So I started off with an 8 when I first started doing nails, but the 8 is just a little too small for me right now, depending on what I'm doing. Mainly, I use a size 10. So I'm just going to run my fingers through the bristle to loosen them up. And I'm gonna use the Meraki Nails monomer. I had a few people recommend this to me as like a lower odor monomer. So we'll see about that. So I'm just gonna dip my brush into the monomer to condition it and get it ready. And I just love the Alpha brushes. The shapes are nice. Got a nice little point to it. And we ready to go. So for this look, I am going to use nail forms. You guys know that I love nail forms. I just feel like I get the best shape with those. So I'm just going to put these on all of my nails. Once I have all of those nail forms on, I'm going to go in with my nail prep. And this is the Mia Secret Nail Prep. It is a dehydrator and it gets rid of all of the oils on your nails. And then I'm going in with the non-acid primer and just apply that to all of my nails as well. The acrylic I'm going to use today is from Not Polish and it is the Nude Panther. This acrylic is a 2-in-1, so it can be used with monomer or as a dip powder. So I'll have to try it with dip and see how it is. But today I'm going to use the monomer. And I'm just going to go in with that bead at the tip and form my nail from the tip first. This is just how I like to work. And I'm using the size 10 Alpha brush. And the first thing I notice about this acrylic is that it works like butter, like for real. I also love that it seems to be like a medium setting, so it does give you time to mold it in shape. Which is always good because I do not work fast. Yeah, I really like this system. I have a ton of other colors of the Not Polish, so I'm excited to try those because this acrylic is like, butter. So yeah, I'm just going in with this as my base color and I'm just gonna form all the nails using this color. And as far as the Meraki monomer, I suppose it was a little less smelly than other monomers, but it still gave me a headache and I wore a mask the whole time. But according to my husband and my daughter, it didn't really smell up the house. So I guess that's a good thing. All right, so this is after forming all of the nails and the acrylic has set. I just make sure to tap it to make sure that everything is completely dry. And then I go ahead and remove the nail forms. So now I'm gonna do my shaping and filing. I like to start off with my hand file first and then I finish up using my e-file around the cuticle area and all of that good stuff. So this is after my nails have been filed, shaped, and buffed. And this shape is just my absolute favorite. So now I'm going in with Madame Glam Gel Polish, and this is called Eco Vibes. And I'm just going to use this polish as the background to this nail because that nail is going to be blinged out. And then I'm going in with the Madame Glam Perfect White Gel Polish. And I'm just going to go ahead and paint my ring finger, middle finger, and index fingernail. And this is after doing 2 coats of that on those nails, of course, curing after each coat. I hadn't decided what I was gonna do with the thumb yet, so I'll get to that later. All right, so now for the printing. I'm going in with the print gel, and this is the PG4. It is like a white gel polish. They said it's like a latex base. I'm not really sure how that works, but the instructions state to put an even layer on your nails. and do not cure. So I did not cure. The gel is still wet. So I'm gonna go ahead and open up the app on my phone. And yes, that is me and hubby's wedding picture. I love that. So go ahead and open the app. And then you have to connect to the printer's Wi-Fi. So I had to switch Wi-Fis. And then now I go back and it will connect. It's telling me to place my finger inside. So that is what I'm gonna do. And I'm going to click it in place. So this is what it looks like on your phone. It shows the camera inside of the printer. So this button here, you can kind of match the size of the nail that you are going for. And then I hit the gallery to see what pictures I want to use. I got all of these little baby pictures from the images on Google. And so I'm just going to pick this one right here, this little cute little chocolate baby boy. And we're going to place him on my nail. So you can use your finger to stretch the image to where it needs to be. So I kind of want it to fit, you know, and then I do have this transparent button where you can press to see exactly where it's going to be on the nail. So once you like that placement, I hit OK and then I confirm the printing and then it starts to print. And once it is finished printing, it will let you know to take your finger out of the printer. And yeah, that was pretty fast. It printed in about a minute. And this is what the little print looks like. Oh, the little chocolate baby is so cute. Now there is a little bit of bleeding around the edges, but this printer did pretty well. I'm quite shocked. So next you have to cure. So I went ahead and cured in my nail lamp for 60 seconds. And I'm just gonna repeat the same thing for my ring fingernail. I wanna print a little baby girl on this one. So yeah, I am quite shocked with the quality of the prints on this one. Now, of course, when you're picking pictures, you wanna pick one that is like as clear as you can get it, a high quality picture. But yeah, this thing prints like on the nail. I'm so shocked, like for real. So it doesn't, you know, hurt or anything when it's printing on it. You can barely feel it. Like, I didn't even feel that it was printing. But that is what the baby girl looks like. Oh, the little chocolate baby girl. Like, oh my God, I cannot believe the quality of these prints. Like, for it to be so small, the quality is great. So I cured that in the nail lamp, and then I'm gonna go in with the top gel. Now this top gel is just like any other gel top coat. So I'm pretty sure you can just use whichever one you want, but I went ahead and used this one to see if it made a difference. So I top coat the printed nails with their top coat, and then I'm using my Poochie's Nails gel top coat for this nail. So after curing, I'm gonna use these acrylics to do some 3D art on my middle fingernail, and I'm gonna use these colors and my Alpha number 2 3D brush, and I'm gonna form a blue pacifier. Or try to anyway.
Ryan Little.
And then I'm gonna do a pink rattle. All right, so of course I need to add some bling. So I'm going in with the Poochie Snails Gel Top Coat and Bling Gel. And I just love the new Gel Top Coat bottles. They are so cute. So first I'm going in with the Bling Gel. And without curing, I'm gonna put the Gel Top Coat on top. And then I'm going in with these pink Swarovski crystals. And then I went in with some clear, high quality iridescent crystals and then some blue Swarovski crystals. And that is just bling. So I went ahead and cured that in my nail lamp. And then I have a tiny strip of bling gel here and I'm just gonna put some caviar beads on. And then I just top coat that with gel top coat. And just make sure all the beads are in place. And then I'm just gonna wipe off the excess gel and I went ahead and cured that in my nail lamp. So for my thumb, I decided to do another printed image and I decided on this image that says boy or girl. So I went ahead and cropped that and we're just gonna go ahead and print that on my thumb. I am addicted to this nail printer, y'all. It is so easy. Like, I really don't enjoy doing hand-drawn art because it takes me hours. But with this printer, I'm able to print off images in less than a minute. So yeah, that's how that turned out. So this is what the nails look like after I applied all of my bling. And I just love how these turned out. So I know you guys want to know if I'm having a boy or a girl. So I'm having a... This is baby girl. And she's moving. Oh, she's so cute.
Little legs right there.
Sleep, I guess.
So yes, I'm having a baby girl and we already have a name picked out and everything. I am so happy. So I will leave my mailing address down below. I've had some people ask me where can they send gifts and stuff like that. I'm not saying that, you know, you have to, but if you want to, I'll leave my mailing address in the info box. But I love how these turned out. They are super, super cute. I had no idea how I wanted to do my gender reveal nails, and I think these turned out so cute. So I know a nail printer is like not in anybody's budget, but I did notice that a lot of nail salons order these. They do have different models with different prices. The differences are just if you want a metal body or if you want a plastic body. And the higher models kind of do more nails. I guess the ink cartridge is bigger so you can print more nails. But according to the FAQs, there's really no difference between the picture quality of any of the printers that they sell, so that's something to think about. I am completely floored at the quality of these prints because I didn't really have high hopes. But yeah, if you guys are interested, I will leave the links down below. I believe they also sell on Amazon as well, so I will leave those links if you guys are interested. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this nail tutorial and I will talk to you in the next one.
This is the outro to the Long Hair Pretty Nail Show. Yeah.